now we're going to check out part three of the preferences to know in Reaper. We're going to go to the Appearance tab and the sub tab named Media. If we click this, there's a few options I want to show you down here called the Media Item Buttons. This decides what we see as buttons right on the media item. Let's close this. Let's get rid of our feeds to make this easier to see. Make it bigger. Unmute it. Right now you can see two buttons. There's a mute button and an eye button, which shows the media properties. But we can have a whole bunch of different ones. And they have two separate states you can view. For instance, there's one for locked and one for not locked. If we choose both of them, there's always a button right here showing us that it's unlocked. If we click it, we can lock this item where we can't move it, depending on how we set it up in our locking settings. But we can click it again and unlock it, all right from the item, which makes it a lot easier. And it gives us visual representation of what's going on. We can see that this item is not locked. But we don't have to view that if we don't want. So we can leave this button off, but leave the lock button viewable. Now we can't click it, but we can right-click it, choose to lock it here, and then we see the button. So we have the option of unlocking it, but not the option of locking it. It really just depends on what you prefer. We could choose to have all of them turned on right here. Now there's a whole bunch of buttons to choose from. We have a locked, unlocked, mute, unmute, notes, where we can add notes for each one of our items. Again, the eye button, which is for properties, which quickly lets us view and edit the properties for that item. I kind of like that one. Also, effects. If we're using item effects, we can add them right here. Click the button, add the effects. Let's use the EQ. And then we can see that this item has effects on it. And click it at any time, and we can edit that effect. And then we have envelopes for that item as well. Click it, adjust the envelope. Let's make one for volume, pan, mute, and pitch. And we can see them all right there. And clicking that button lets us readjust them or turn them off. Now, if this gets too clogged, which it does for me, let's turn off this effect right here. And the notes, let's delete them. If it gets too clogged, just turn off these ones at the bottom, which is how I usually do it. This way you don't see them all unless there's something to actually see. For instance, if we mute it, then that button appears, letting us know if this item is muted. Or if we add effects, under take effects, it shows up that there's an effect on that item, which to me is worth having. This way you know what's going on at any given time. And if we delete it, we don't see it anymore. So we could choose to see them all or just when it's necessary. But I prefer to have not muted always there. This way there's always a button to quickly mute this item. Mute it, unmute it. Or check out the properties right here. So that's the media item buttons in the Appearance Media tab, right over here. Next, we're going to check out the editing behavior down here. Now, this is important. This decides how Reaper behaves when we're editing, and it throws a lot of people off. The first option is to move the edit cursor to the start of the time selection on time selection change. So if we click this, let's hit OK. Let's mute this for now. If we create a time selection over here, the play cursor or edit cursor moves to the beginning of it. Do the same thing over here or over here. It automatically moves, losing the play cursor's place. So if you don't want that, make sure you turn this off. Now they're independent. So if I select over here, my play cursor is still over here, allowing me to play from this point without moving it over here. The next option is to move the edit cursor or play cursor when pasting or inserting media. If we choose this, now let's cut this and paste it right here. It automatically puts the play cursor or edit cursor at the end, which is useful for looping. Let's scroll out. Let's paste again. We could just continually paste, and it creates loops by pasting the piece of audio or item right at the end. So that saves some time. Scroll out a bit more. Just keep pasting. But with this turned off, it's not going to behave that way. So let's delete these. Let's cut this. Now if we paste it, the play cursor or edit cursor stays where it started. So we have to move it every time we want to paste. Again, it's just a preference, but it saves some time to know it exists. And it also saves frustration if Reaper's not behaving how you want it to. The next option is to move the edit cursor to the end of recorded items on stop. So if we choose this and go into record, every time we stop, the play cursor or edit cursor is going to stop right there. Again, it's just an editing behavior, but if you prefer it to behave this way, it'll save us a bunch of time. We could also choose to link loop points to the time selection. Most of the time I leave this on. So if I create an edit selection like this, and looping or repeat is turned on down here, it's going to loop that section because the edit selection and the looping selection are the same thing. But we can separate that and create two separate things. Turn this off. Now, if we click up here, that creates our loop. Let's make it a bit smaller. So Reaper is going to loop in that section. But if we want to edit a different section at the same time, while this is looping, we can still do that by selecting over here instead of in the time ruler. So it gives us more options. But most of the time, I leave them linked. Our loop and our time selection are the same thing. We could also clear the time selection when we click in the arrange view. So if this is selected, we have something selected here. Every time we click, it goes away. Even if we're playing. So if you don't want that to happen, make sure you uncheck this. And now clicking over here doesn't remove the time selection. Instead, we could hit escape. And we could also choose to clear loop points by clicking on the ruler. Click this one. Click up here. It goes away. But not down here. That one is based on this check. So if we want to click in the tracks, we do this one. Or click on the ruler, we choose this one. Or deselect it if we don't want that to happen. And hit escape instead. So that's some of the edit cursor behavior. And that's the end of part 3. Let's move on to part 4 of the preferences to know in Reaper.